please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
SP Tulsian of SPTulsian.com with us. Good morning, sir. First up, the AMCs, now they have to pay a little more, they have to charge their customers a little less, about 0.5% in very large AMCs, over 50,000 crore. Now, various brokerages are giving us some estimate on Reliance, it may be a 17% impact, HDFC AMC, 25%. How do you approach these stocks?
See, Lata, maybe one has to be very selective because, in fact, if you see the situation going forward, the things are seem to be going positive for the investor friendly. But we have been taking a call that you have started seeing the listing of these mutual fund stocks, you know, on the bourses. But if I just take a call, positive call, we continue to have a positive bias on the HDFC AMC and not on the other mutual fund stocks. Because even if you see this reduction in the mutual fund, ultimately the flow or the pace at which the things are flowing in, and in fact the incremental or maybe the mix of the equity and debt, you know, which is seen more than 50% for HDFC AMC, you know, is seen to be working in their favor. And in fact, if you take the valuation call also, you know, on the listing day, if you all recall, all the unanimous buy call were given, and post that the stock has corrected by about 20%. So, but one should not perceive this reduction as negative for the mutual fund, because ultimately it is the growth which will be driving the earnings of these mutual funds. It is something, you know, it reminds me of the 1995 when the custom duties, you know, got reduced from 120% to 20%, when the Indian industries were all crying that they will not exist. So this is not that one should not view this as a negative for the mutual fund sector. In fact, the momentum and pace, the growth which will be seen is going to drive the industry going forward, and which will be quite advantageous for the larger mutual fund companies.
Mr. Sen, good morning. The other stock that I wanted to discuss with you is Wipro, if you have looked at that, because that's been moving in just one direction, up 10% this month, correcting a lot of its underperformance compared to the sector. What's your view on the stock?
See, Anuj, maybe this is catching up now, because if you really take a call on all other IT stocks, maybe whether it, in fact, it has started with TCS, I'm referring the price behavior of IT stocks, the larger ones in this last 4 or 5 months. It has started with TCS, followed by HCL Tech, then Infosys, and then Tech Mahindra. In fact, Wipro has not seen having participated at all. And in fact, many of the mid-cap IT stocks, maybe like Tata Elxsi, Cyient, and, you know, Persistent System, in fact, all of them have performed quite well. So maybe this is just seen a catch-up, but I won't be taking even after the stock seen having risen by about 10%, the investment call now on the stock at the current level.
Okay, Mr. Tulsian, good morning. I wanted your views on Titan. You know, there is a fear that the possible hike in import duty on gold would impact names like Titan. This morning, in fact, CLSA has downgraded Titan. They've cut the target price to 720 versus 1050 earlier. How do long-term investors approach this stock now?
See, Sonia, I think if you are a long-term investor, remain invested. Because if you go by the statement of the MD of the company, Mr. Bhatt, you know, he has been very clear that the kind of growth targets which have been given till 2023 is indicating 22 to 24% growth in the jewelry segment, and that is going to be seen quite positive. Coming specifically on the gold import duty hikes, you know, that will be seen as a pass-through for the company. It may be sentimentally for a couple of days may look negative. Now, coming on the near term, or maybe for next 2-3 months horizon, in fact, we have initiated a buy call on the stock for last two, three days, because if you really see the trading range of the stock, it is moving in a range of maybe about 830 to about 900-910, and now it is ruling at a lower end of the range. And in fact, maybe Q2 would be seen little softer, but it is not that, you know, you have the Q2 numbers due maybe at least after 1 month away, and you cannot expect the shares to fall further. So in fact, we have been initiating buy call, and if you are a long-term investor, I think the current price warrants an investment at the current level.
Okay. Well, the other stock I wanted to ask you, Mr. Tulsian, is realty stocks. You know, increasingly we are getting brokerages saying that probably the stocks are troughing out, and you know, that they could be buy candidates. Just this morning we have a positive report from Citi, and they're recommending Phoenix Mills. Though they still keep a sell on DLF, we have a Macquarie report saying Prestige and Phoenix Mills are buys, and I think yesterday we had even Morgan Stanley seeing Prestige, Oberoi, etc. are buys. Your take on the sector and what stocks do you like?
See, Lata, in fact, we have the positive view on the realty developers. Now, if I take a call on Phoenix, it cannot be, they are just the real estate company, you know, on which they have the annuity income. I won't be calling as a developer. But if you really go the situation going forward, in fact, after this GST and RERA, you know, 1 year have elapsed on both. And that has seen a seamless integration now happening. And probably the demand have started picking up in the if I take a call on the Mumbai region. In fact, the demand has been seen quite good in Bangalore, in the southern part of the country. And in fact, the things have started improving in the Mumbai region also, maybe with the ticket size of up to 2 crore. So the concentrated buying, you know, which we have not seen happened, having taken place in the city for the last about couple of years, is seen to be, you know, is coming in now. In fact, the permissions have not been given by the Bombay Municipal Corporations, maybe because of the fire issues and all that. So no, not much new projects are coming in. So yes, we are in fact keeping quite positive view. And in that context, maybe our first pick from the Mumbai real estate will be Indiabulls Real Estate, because they will be completing their blue project, you know, at Worli, for which the possessions have already started being given to the buyers. So yes, keeping positive view from the Mumbai real estate, I have a positive call on Indiabulls Real Estate. We continue to be positive on the Prestige Estate and maybe Sobha also, because the kind of performance which we have seen from Sobha, maybe DLF will be little, you know, will be on the hold, not giving a buying recommendation. But these three stocks are looking good from the real estate sector.
Okay. Mr. Chan, we discussed this yesterday as well. Is the sugar rally over with the move yesterday, or is this just a correction in this ongoing big rally?
See, Anuj, in fact, I have been saying this, you know, you need to look to the fundamentals of the sugar sector per se, you know, going forward. And I have said that there will only be the cut or the halt on the losses. Probably you can take a call that if the 10 million ton of sugar production is diverted for making ethanol, because this coming season sugar production is estimated, if I just go on the old formula, sugar production is estimated at 35 million ton, which cannot get absorbed. If 35 million tons sugar gets produced, the prices will fall to 26 rupees, which will see huge losses being incurred by the sugar company. So if the 10 million ton sugar is diverted for making ethanol, then you can rest assured that the realization of the sugar will be closer to about 32 rupees per kg, plus the realization from the ethanol also. On the end, it works out on parity, you know, with the way, if you sacrifice the sugar production and make ethanol, you have a parity, because after the increase in the ethanol prices being seen from B molasses to 53 rupees per liter. So I won't be taking this as an incremental something, you know, positive coming in on the earning fronts, which we have seen in case of FY16 for the sugar companies. This is just that there won't be any losses, and the kind of run up which we have seen of 35 to 50% in this last 1 week or so, or maybe last couple of weeks, it has, you know, doesn't justify further upside from here. On the contrary, you may be having the risk of, you know, maybe some profit booking coming in. So yes, we have in fact advised, you know, in a couple of days back also, I've said that when the frenzy was seen, maybe I think day before on Monday, that the buying is not advised at the current level. Stocks seem to have run up quite a lot.
Okay. This is despite the fact that the cabinet committee today may look at giving some export subsidy for about 50 lakh tons. That's not material.
See, Lata, that is seen for the current inventory, because even we at the current inventory seem to be quite high at about 10-11 million ton. And I don't know, the transport subsidy of 2,500 per ton is being talked, whether that kind of subsidy will be given or not. And I honestly, if you really see the situation, that yes, once this inventory goes away, then probably, you know, maybe looked into that yes, the things are returning back to the normalcy, which has already seen having factored into the price. So I won't be that gung-ho and not that optimistic seen coming in on the top of the transport subsidy of 2,500 rupees per ton, and maybe sugar cane subsidy of about 140 rupees per quintal kind of things, 140 per ton kind of things.
Okay.